today there has been some pressing news regarding the Flint water.
And DTV hit the road to watch Undrinkable at the Traverse City Film Festival.
And some rockets are flying through the sky today. All this and more, DTV News starts right now.
There's been some breaking news in the Flint water crisis. I'm Abigail Fulcher.
And I'm Bailey Talaska. The scientist who has been monitoring lead tests in the water says the crisis is over. There was a press conference this morning at Virginia Tech University. Mark Edwards, a professor at Virginia Tech, and his research team have found that after 5 rounds of testing, the lead levels are only slightly below normal. They will continue to monitor the levels, but for now they are saying the crisis is finally ended, according to the testing. But it will take a while to repair the damage and the trust that has been broken.
If you define the end of the water crisis as having water quality parameters back in the range considered normal for other cities with old lead pipes, the answer is yes. Obviously, there's still a crisis of confidence amongst Flint residents that's not going to be restored anytime soon, that's beyond the reach of science to solve, but it can only be addressed by years of trustworthy behavior by government agencies who unfortunately lost that trust deservedly in the first place.
As the Flint water crisis unfolds, we will be along for the ride. To see any of our previous work, go to dtvnews.org and you can find everything we have ever done under the Flint Water Crisis tab. 3, 2, 1, blast off. Rockets were launching all over the place and it wasn't North Korea. Mr. Prim's 9th grade physical science classes have been launching off rockets. The students made the rockets out of used 2-liter bottles and have used the right amount of water to test the pressure. Already in need of a break from school? Well, October 30th through November 2nd will be our first intercession, so you can relax at home, or if you'd like to sign up for any intercession activities, you can find forms in the main office. The deadline is September 29th.
If your dancing partner for homecoming is not from this school, then be sure to fill out the guest forms. Forms are available in the main office and are due back by noon on September 29th. If you do not turn one of these forms in, your guests will not be able to attend. And if you are just planning on attending homecoming this year, tickets will go on sale the week of the dance and in the cafeteria at lunch for $5, and a ticket will be $7 at the door. Emmanuel Clinton will have all the news on yesterday's swim team win and tonight's away football game.
The biggest and scariest thing is just not knowing.
Just, you know, this governor, he's behind all this.
We need a concrete plan and stop finger pointing and kind of get real.
Hello, Davison. I'm Emmanuel Quillen with today's sports. Let's dive right in. The girls' swim and dive team dominated yesterday, winning both their meets. The Davison Lady Cards won 106-79 to Corona and 115-70 to Holly, with lots of first-place wins. Ashlyn Hopkins in the 200 free, Maya Manley in the 500 free and 100 free, Joanna Osborne in the 100 fly and 500 free, Kaylee Vo in the 100 breaststroke, Abby Trombley in diving, and Emily Moriarty in 100 back.
I think our team has been doing amazing. I'm super proud of each and every one of them. From the first day of practice to now, I can definitely tell a difference. We work our butts off in that pool, and it's definitely paying off, getting best times in first place more and more every single meet.
Swim and dive team will be kicking back up next Tuesday at the Saginaw Heritage Meet. Last week, the varsity football team went up against Carmen and blew them away with 50-13, keeping up their score so far undefeated this season. Tonight, our Cardinal play at Atwood Stadium against Flint Jaguars at 7. The cost will be $5. This is expected to be a big game, so we're hoping to see you there. Go Cards! Are you interested in playing hockey? Go. Good news, next Monday, September 18th, there's an informational meeting for the hockey team. If you want to try out, bring those parents, and it's at 6:00 in the AMR. The robotics team will be facing off at Kettering University this Saturday. If you would like to join, it is recommended that you attend. Contact Mr. Renard if you have any questions. Well, that's all I have for you today in sports. I'll toss things over to the one and only Tyler Theodore has this weekend's forecast. What's it like out there, Tyler?
It's looking pretty good, Emmanuel. Now, I'm Tyler Theodore. Let's get started for Friday. Now, I can't believe it's already Friday. We're talking 80s, folks. I am talking the 80s, and you will have sunglasses because it's going to be a hot weekend for Saturday. Mostly sunny, 82 degrees, and Sunday of highs 81 degrees and low 59 degrees. And I'm Tyler Theodore for your DTV News, and I'll see you next time.
Thanks, Tyler. Choosing what college to go to is a difficult decision to make, so make sure you can make the right choice and colleges are coming to visit you. On the 26th of this month, Michigan State will be here at 9:45. Next, the University of Chicago will be here on October 2nd at 1:30. Cornerstone will be here at 8:45, and Oakland will be here at 1:15 on October 11th. And lastly, Central will be here on October 17th at 8:45. To sign up for any of these visits, go to the Career Center.
Michigan has been a beacon for the manufacturing world for over a century, and there are good-paying jobs available in the field. If you are interested in taking a tour and learning about how factories work and what kind of jobs are in that field, you can sign up to tour some local companies in October. Spots are filling up fast, and the deadline to sign up is next Friday. Stop into the Career Center for more information. It could lead to a career in skilled trades and manufacturing.
Over the summer, some of us DTV crew took a trip up north to the Traverse City Film Festival. The festival had a whole section on Flint-based documentaries, and DTV's Undrinkable was one of them. We have the story in our big screen debut.
Davison is at, but it's right next to Flint. So when we started getting news of what was happening, and we had to compile a lot of information, but we were sort of under an obligation to tell the story of Flint.
DTV has been covering the Flint water crisis from the beginning, working hard to get our Flint neighbors the justice they deserve. So when DTV was asked if our documentary Undrinkable could be played at the Traverse City Film Festival, of course, we said yes and made the trip up north. Undrinkable was played alongside other films that were based on the Flint water crisis, such as Here's to Flint by Kirk Guyette.
Kirk is, backstage I said, the example of a heroic journalist. This is the man that broke the story on Flint, Michigan.
And a preview of Anthony Baxter's documentary about the long-lasting effects of the crisis. And two DTV alums were asked to speak on the panel.
Merrick, Alum and Haley Thompson from Davidson, Michigan.
It was such an honor for DTV to be able to stand alongside such accomplished filmmakers.
I noticed you guys also, there would be the CBS microphone and the Davidson Cardinals with only two microphones in front of these people quite often.
It is great that the festival and other filmmakers are making sure Flint is not forgotten.
The crisis in Flint is ongoing. You know, the mainstream media was slow to recognize the issue. Then they came in droves, and then they went away. But the problem did not go away.
And as we can see by today's events, while the crisis in Flint has gotten better, it is not over.
Having a little extra help with college tuition is always a really good thing to have. Here are some scholarship opportunities to help with just that. The Abe Maria Scholarship gives you the opportunity to get $75,000 a year. To apply, go to www.abemarie.com/apply. Next, Daniel Pearl World Music Day Journalism Essay Scholarship is due on the 11th at 5 p.m. The Horatio Alger Association is due on October 25th and could get you up to $25,000 for college. And on April 1st, the William G. Coyne Memorial Scholarship will be due. Head to the guidance office for more information and opportunities.
It is always nice to keep up to date on what's happening in your area. Give us a follow on DTV_official so you always know what's going on in the world of news. Later on DTV, we will be re-airing the Carmen Ainsworth game at 12:30 and 7:30, so tune in to see our boys dominate.
Miss anything from today's newscast or want to rewatch our Traverse City story? Head on over to our website, dtvnews.org. So, you know, the Flint water thing today, it's crazy that we've been working with it for so long and we're finally just now seeing change.
Yeah, it's great that it's getting better, but there's still a lot of trust that needs to be repaired.
But, you know, it's still surprising to see that the level was that low.
Well, yeah.
I'm Emmanuel Clinton alongside Bailey Telaska and Abigail Fulcher. Have a great day, Davidson.